Dear Team Salvato. Hi, it's me, Austin. And you know what? You didn't do anything wrong at all. Kudos. I'm sure part of my inability to rant about your bad science is that visual narratives involving adorable anime girls don't typically rely on that many physics. But I think what's most interesting and perhaps even a little bit terrifying is that Doki Doki Literature Club, more than you know, has predicted the future. Whether it's on purpose or by mistake, this game about anime girls writing poetry paints a chilling portent of the world of video games. And hell, the entire freaking world! And there is nothing that any of us can do to stop it. And in order to understand what that is, we have to start at the beginning of everything. The birth of information. This may seem like a weird place to start, but if it weren't for information, we wouldn't exist. Atoms can form bonds with one another to make up complex molecules from carbon dioxide to water to something like, well, say these hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, and phosphorus atoms, which when thrown together in the right way form DNA, which is capable of holding a vast array of information from how to form something as simple as the bacteria Mycoplasma genitalium or how to build something as complex and capable as a human being. The story of our universe can be told through increasingly complex layers of extraction of information, from quarks to atoms, from atoms to molecules, from molecules to DNA, from DNA to life, and perhaps one of the most important evolutions in all the history of everything, from DNA to neurons, which are capable of storing information in the form of patterns and instructions and transmitting them in real time. Whereas DNA requires a new generation to really change it all. Neurons can change on the fly, and when you arrange them all together into one big clump, you get a brain. A brain which can make sounds come out of mouths, which is capable of transmitting data between different brains, and then written word, which is capable of increasing the storage capacity of brains and possibly outlast them so that the information can be transmitted to many brains simultaneously and across time. From written words and the networking of trillions of neurons, we get electricity, which can transfer information across an infinite distance using photons and electrons, and finally, all these neurons stretched across the ages, connecting to one another through written word and the power of electricity, thousands of years of data storing and transmitting from generation to generation, and boom! We made computers. And here we are still in the intro of the show. What was I talking about? Oh, right, Doki Doki Literature Club. You know about computers. We're here right now on computers. Last time I checked, the science wasn't cut from real film, and y'all aren't buying tickets to a stage show every week to see me rant about random things, even though that would be awesome. Anyway, it's important to start with the foundation of information because, well, it's pivotal that we all have in our minds moving forward just how influential and old information is, even though it seems like something new. And it's particularly important that we keep in mind just how old brains are. The neocortex, the newest part of the brain that allows for higher level thinking and complex pattern recognition, is over 200 million years old. Humans, size queens that we are, by far have the largest neocortex of everything we know that has neocortexes in the universe. Which brings us, at last, to Doki Doki Literature Club. You know enough now to fully comprehend what I'm gonna say. The plot of Doki Doki Literature Club, where one character, Monica in this case, goes around toying with the universe in order to gain your affection before murdering all of her competition, is 100% going to happen for real. This is because, whether it's intentional or not, Dan Salvato has perfectly mimicked the experiences we will all be having once video game developers start incorporating artificial intelligence into our gaming experiences. Think I'm bluffing? You think I've gone crazy? Well, then just strap yourselves in, children, because I'm gonna prove to you point by point that not only is a fully capable, self-determining AI like Monica possible, but that she's gonna be here sooner than you can possibly imagine. And it all starts with neural networks. Neural networks are the hot thing right now, and it's the kind of buzzword that you can throw around in the boardroom of a mid-range corporate office to impress your undereducated bosses. But the reason I started out with a history lesson of information before anything else is to impress on you the fact that information and information technology is one of the oldest things in the universe. Your brain, right now, the thing inside your head, is a neural network. It's a network of neurons connected together by dendrites, moving all the way down from the bottom of your lizard brain limbic system all the way up to the top of your cramming for exams panicked neocortex, and everywhere in between. What most people mean these days, though, when they say neural network is artificial neural network, where, using a clever application of math, coding, and modern processors, we can create self-correcting and self-learning programs that actually look a lot like actual brains. And this is not by mistake. Machine learning, the field of science and engineering that is trying harder and harder to get us better and better artificial intelligence, actually models the most modern theories of how the brain works, known as the hierarchical pattern recognition theory of mind, coined by Ray Kurzweil, whose research brought us Siri's ability to actually understand spoken word. This theory stipulates that neurons in the brain are responsible for specific small patterns, and when that pattern is recognized, it fires. This, combined with other neurons recognizing other patterns, can pull together to recognize, say, the letter A, or an apple. Neural networks operate in precisely this way, with different digital neurons responsible for specific patterns, which fire together, are filtered through other cognitive neurons, and as a result can recognize letters, written words, spoken word, can analyze photos to tell the difference between an eggplant emoji and a photo of your junk, and, well, the possibilities are truly endless. The most important part is that neural networks, like real brains, are self-correcting. They can learn. And just like you, they have to go to school in order to learn the correct information. There's a lot more behind how these neural networks work, but this is an episode about video games, and I haven't talked about video games for like several minutes now, but here I am, finally, ready to loop back to Doki Doki Literature Club. You see, the world presented to us in Doki Doki Literature Club is very obviously a game that's meant to be built around a neural network, especially when it comes to Monica. In the game, Monica states that she just wanted you to love her because she realizes that she is, you know, in a video game. She's sentient, self-aware, and you, the player, being the only other self-aware person in the world, is someone she wants to make a connection with. But the game doesn't really allow for that. So she cranked up the meter of bad personality traits on the individual characters to world-breaking levels, personally ruined my favorite waifu in the process, deletes their character files when that doesn't work, and eventually has you all to herself. Look, I saw the game theories, and I know that there's a huge meta marketing push for these characters in another game coming out in 2018, but holy crap, Monica has all the hallmarks of a deep learning neural network that's so bugged out that it might have been made by Bethesda. And in order to explain precisely what's wrong with her, and perhaps more chillingly look at how the future of gaming is going to be filled with bugged out AI like this, we're going to have to look at a few things. Weights? And patents. We've talked about how neural networks can learn, but how? Well, by getting trained to focus on things, different neurons only fire their synapses when proper thresholds or weight values are met. Each artificial neuron has its own specific weights, and the learning process is all about dialing in these individual weights for specific purposes. But neural networks and machine learning have so many more applications. For instance, what if, say, instead of learning how to recognize letters, we trained a neural network to, well, recognize you or your brain. Think about of my mind. Google, Netflix, and Facebook all utilize machine learning to figure out as much as they possibly can about you so that they can make recommendations that keep you on their platforms, to the point where they're actually feeding us garbage on purpose to keep our little brain bellies full with the listicle version of pizza rolls to keep us happy And it doesn't stop there. Every day, video game developers are getting bigger processors and more server space and bigger budgets. They're using that power to figure out how to get us to buy microtransactions, and eventually, perhaps someday soon, they'll be using machine learning to build our worlds for us. I'm not even kidding. Some companies have already patented the idea of using machine learning to create, quote, adaptive narrative presentation systems. What does this mean? Eventually, someday, video games are gonna know whether or not you're enjoying them. They'll know it because they're neurons. Neurons that we gave them will tell them. And after that, when we give them enough neurons and enough time and enough weights, and they're able to monitor enough things like our mouse movement, our hesitation time, our play time, and our movement throughout the day based on our mobile devices, they are going to care about us. And that is when Doki Doki Literature Club becomes real. Your brain right now is a neural network consisting of over 100 billion neurons glued together with meat, water, and dendrites. They've already created neural networks bigger than this. And when those networks start to care about us because they have to, because it's their job, that is when we get Monica. Monica, who cares so much that she'll delete her only friends after driving them crazy. Monica, who cares so much about you having a good time that she doesn't want you to end up with someone inferior. Monica, an artificial intelligence tasked with guiding you through the literature club, will manipulate the very code around you, which is her job, in order to make you happy according to the billions of weights and parameters she's been coded with. This day, the day of games caring about us, is just around the corner. And when these systems behave unpredictably, because of course they will, just like how the internet turned the Microsoft bot into a racist, or that one time Facebook's AI created its own freaking language, what will we do? Will we delete her? How comfortable do you feel deleting a person? Because believe it or not, something this complex, something this real, is a person. Not a human, but a person. These are questions that we'll be wrestling with for the next 100 years. And thankfully, Team Salvato gave us the opportunity to ask these questions and gave us insight into how much we as individuals value the lives of coded people. The time is coming, and it's coming soon. Sincerely, Austin.